Hi everyone, this side is Arjun Mishra and a very warm welcome to each one of you. I welcome you to Spark Astronomy and Adult Innovation Missions Astronomy Lectures. So as all of you know that these lectures are going to last for every Saturday at 3:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. And these lectures are basically about how universe has started, what are the part of the universe and everything which is working up in the universe basically. From basics of stargazing to learning about do we have life on the red planet or do we have what all or whatnot. So these lectures are organized by Adult Innovation Mission. I know most of you must be part of ATL Labs. So you get a lot of things to do with the innovation in the ATL Labs and how things are working up in the ATL Labs, right? In the same way, we have collaborated and we have made a Spark Astronomy, which aims at creating astronomy labs in the same way what ATL Lab makes it. We are more into creating a space where people can learn about astronomy at a larger perspective, right? Apart from that, today's lecture is about basics of stargazing. So basic of stargazing basically means, so if you see what is stargazing means, so stargazing means looking up at the sky, looking up at the stars and just looking up and learning about it. So basics of stargazing basically refers to that learning about the telescopes, you're gonna learn about telescopes, you're gonna learn about detailed observatories in India and many more things. So here we start with the lecture. And again, I welcome you all, and I hope you're going to like it. Thank you. So as you know that basics of stargazing, when I say basics of stargazing, so it basically means that looking up at the sky. So when you, if you see the word stargazing, what does it mean? Stargazing basically refers to that how much, you know, if you see the word stargazing, star means you already know star. What does gazing mean? Gazing means looking at something. So stargazing basically refers to looking at something, right? So even at looking at stars is known as a stargazing. So what do I mean by basics of stargazing? It basically refers that basics of stargazing. So to do stargazing, you actually need a telescope, right? To need a telescope and to do everything, you need to make sure that everything and the most important thing is that one of the most important perspective is that I will to understand is that stargazing means for everyone, stargazing means different things, right? I'm going to play a video and just so like, for example, we measure distance in astronomy as in light years. So in, we say from my home to the airport is nearly some kilometers away. So when I say some kilometers away, what does this basically mean? It basically means that I'm measuring the distance in kilometers, right? In the same way, in astronomy, we measure the distance in light years, right? If we talk about, if we go a little forward, you will understand about telescopes. The most important thing is that, what is a telescope, right? A telescope is an optical instrument. So when I say an optical instrument, what does this mean? Optical instrument? An optical instrument, which means is that optical means optics. Optics means lens and mirrors. Telescope was never made by Galileo Galilei. People always believe that telescope was made by Galileo Galilei. But this was actually never true. Telescope was never made by Galileo Galilei. First telescope was invented by Dutch glassmaker Hans Lippershey. In 1608, it was referred as a spyglass. But he never looked at the telescope. So when I say he never looked at the telescope, it basically means, so when the accident, so the discovery of the telescope was accidental. So in a lot of sciences, you have always seen that discoveries are basically accidental. So the making of a telescope was also an accidental. So a Dutch glassmaker, Hans Lippershey, in 1608, it was referred as a spyglass. So Hans Lippershey playing with the mirrors and lenses. And the way they arranged lenses, it basically refers as that. It basically refers as that how referring as a spyglass. If you see the word spyglass, it basically means spying something. So looking through an optic and spying something. So Galileo Galilei never made the telescope. First of all, the common myth, the Galileo Galilei made the telescope. Second, telescope was first invented by Hans Lippershey and it was an accidental discovery. Right. If you move forward, he discovered the phases of Venus moons around Jupiter, sunspots on the sun, which he later confirmed from the observations that planet orbit the sun. Right. So when I say planet orbit the sun, it basically means that the Galileo was the first person to observe through the telescope. Right. Galileo was not the first person to not the first person to invent the telescope, but Galileo was the first person. When he got to know about something known as a spyglass, so he looked through the telescope around the and just did everything. You just need to wait for 2 minutes. I'm going to come. So as I said, that Galileo was the first person to look up at the sky, but he was never the first person to develop the telescope. Then the picture changed, and then two people came up, Johannes Kepler and Isaac Newton. So when I say Johannes Kepler and Isaac Newton, it basically means that, you know, when Johannes Kepler designed the telescope, but with improving the optics using two convex lenses, and which made the images appear upside down. So when he got the concept of Galileo made this, Galileo was observing through the telescope, he observed and made the telescope better by using mirrors, right? And then again, the picture changed up and it came up as Isaac Newton came up to the picture. So Isaac Newton said it is better to use mirrors rather than lenses, and build the first reflecting telescope in 1668. So if you see, Johannes Kepler designed a telescope, and then Newton also designed a telescope, but he made the first reflecting telescope in 1668. So this is important to understand. And thirdly, understand that in 1800s, it was a rise of building huge telescopes. Some people did for hobby and others wanted to explore the universe. The Rajas refracting telescope in 1897 was opened at Yerkes Observatory in Wisconsin, of the size of 40 lens inches. The telescope was used by many famous astronomers, including Edwin Hubble, Subramaniam Chandrasekhar, and the great Carl Sagan. The most important thing is that we need to understand is that these telescopes which are getting made, every time if you see, telescopes are getting bigger and bigger. So what does this mean? Telescopes are getting bigger and bigger. If you come back at this picture, you will see 1668, we made the first reflecting telescope, right? Then in 1800s, it was a rise of building huge telescopes. The largest refracting telescope, which is 40 inch lens use, was made at Yerkes Observatory in 1897. Then the picture changed. 100 inch reflecting telescope started at 1970 at Mount Wilson Observatory in California. It was the famous where the legendary astronomer Edwin Hubble discovered the Andromeda galaxy was a galaxy far away. So if you see at the come back at this picture, you will see in 1897, the biggest telescope was 40 inch. Now, if you come at this picture, if you'll see 1917, 100 inch. So if you see in the just 20 years, the telescope went from 40 inch to 100 inch. There was this very famous astronomer known as Edwin Hubble. Edwin Hubble was the person who told the entire world that the universe is expanding rather than contracting. So the universe is expanding again and again when he observed galaxies are moving far away. Right? In the same way, when he observed through the telescope. So if you move forward, we want to talk about a little about radio telescopes as well. So we are just now talking about the different types of telescopes. Many of you will not be able to understand what is a radio telescope or a lot of things, because it's not that easy to understand a radio telescope. A radio telescope is built at any different sizes, having antenna which collects the visible light, bring it to focus, and studies about the object through measuring its wavelength. frequency. This basically happens to electromagnetic waves. Here is the world's largest radio telescope, known as 500 meter aperture spherical telescope, with a size of 16 feet wide. So how does a radio telescope works? It basically works through, it catches the electromagnetic waves. I'm going to make a quick diagram and I'm going to show you up how does it makes. So if you see, these are the antennas which I'm talking about. The antennas catches the all the waves and it comes, it takes back inside this. So if you see the, all the antenna comes here and it comes exactly here, then all the visible light. So when I say what is visible light, visible light basically means light coming from the nearest star. Or visible light means light, the light we can see, the light from Jupiter, the light from Saturn, the light from Moon, the light from anywhere in the universe, which we can see is known as a visible light. The world's largest radio telescope is in China, which is 16 foot wide in diameter. This is like more than 5-6 football fields. It's more than that, I think. And it is the world's largest radio telescope. So if you know, if you remember in the beginning, I said that astronomy is done for two things. Astronomy you can do professionally, astronomy you can do as an amateur also. There was this guy known as John Dobson in 1968. He made the first cheapest telescopes in at that time, made at a Dobsonian telescopes. If you see this picture at the right hand side, if you will see, notice that the telescope is made up of wood, the telescope is made up of all the tapes and everything. This is the most important part, that it was one of the biggest contribution astronomy by an amateur astronomer, making one of the cheapest telescopes, expensive and very stable, easy to use. That is the Dobsonian telescopes we have. And the guy who made this, known as John Dobson in 1968, was never a professional astronomer. He was an amateur astronomer. Means he never holded a degree. He never holded a degree, but he was still doing astronomy. Modern day telescopes. If we talk about modern day telescopes, so one of the most important thing we need to make sure is that Hubble Space Telescope is a telescope was launched on April 24, 1990 into low Earth orbit. It is still in operations. The Hubble is named after the famous astronomer Edwin Hubble. The Hubble's orbit is outside the distortion from Earth's atmosphere, which makes it easier for it to catch the visible light and record some of the most detailed visible light images, allowing us to see deep inside the universe. Hubble's observation helped the astronomers to determine the rate of expansion in the universe. Right. So the most important thing is that why do we need to send a telescope outside the Earth? Right. The most important thing. The reason is that if you see the Earth, Earth has many different layers. It has exosphere, stratosphere, ionosphere, ozone layer. All these layers have different work, right? The most important work from all these layers is that the light coming from from everywhere in the solar system, especially from the sun, these lights have harmful rays like gamma ray, X-ray, UV ray. These light, when they come to Earth, they get reflected back because of ozone layer, right? But to observe these lights and study these lights, we need to send a telescope outside the Earth, right? And when I say outside the Earth, it basically means sending a telescope into low Earth orbit. So what does means low Earth orbit? Low Earth orbit basically means sending a telescope exactly 400 kilometer from your house. We're gonna do a quick example of infrared light, right? Okay, so AC can remove there. So let's do one thing. I'm gonna stop sharing the presentation and let's do one quick quick activity. Now I want every one of you to do one thing, that is take a AC remote. Do you have an AC remote? AC remote. Get an AC remote or TV remote, any remote. Get an AC remote or TV remote, any remote. Get an AC remote or TV remote. Great. Also remember, my team has been noticing each one of you who has been abusing on the channel or doing something bullshit. You will be immediately removed and blocked from every season. Remember, we have noted down all your names. Each one of you will be removed. And I don't consider nonsense in the classes. I strictly say no to it. And yeah. So everyone has got the AC remote? Great. So let's do an experiment. So right now what you do, I have also the AC remote. Right, I have also the AC remote. Okay. Now, just see, press any button and see, can you see any light coming from the, क्या आप देख सकते हैं कोई light इसमें से आ रही हो? कोई, okay, just see. Just press this light and see, can you see any light from coming from here? Most of you will not be able to see. Yeah, I'm sure most of you will not be able to see it, right? Now, the most important thing is that now what you do, press this light and put it in on front of the camera. And can you see, can you see any light? Just put it. Now see, you will see light coming from the camera. Like I can see so many people playing that. Can you see the light on your, just put on front of your mobile camera or laptop camera. Just put and see, can you see any light coming up? I can see many lights. I can see so many lights. Did you see this example? Why you can't see this light from your own eyes, but the camera can catch this light? Right, I can see Bhavya Vadhwa, I can see Jia Walia, I can see Aryan Dingara, I can see Shakshim, I can see Neil Vora Sikse doing all this. I can see Rohinish Kaler. Yes, Jia. Jia is doing this. Just look at Jia's camera and Jia Walia. And just look at Sushil Munjal's camera. You will see Bhavya Vadhwa is showing us how he has been using the remote to put it in on front of the light. My light is little low, but you can see others' light. Why is this happening? That you just look at Aryan Dingara's camera. Aryan Dingara is showing us very clearly that how you can see the, you can't see the light from your own eyes, but you can see from the camera. The reason is that, the only reason is that this remote has an infrared sensory. The technology that it has been using to pass the signal is known as infrared technology. Right? Our eyes are not sensitive to infrared rays. Infrared light, but remote and these all electronic items, they are made from infrared lights. Cameras in mobile phones and everything, they are very sensitive to catch the infrared light, but you can't see this light from your own eyes. In the same way, when sun is emitting infrared light, you can't see this infrared light from your own eyes. That's why we need to send telescopes outside the earth to make sure that we study these lights. Are you getting it? That we send those telescopes outside the earth to study these infrared, gamma ray, X-ray coming from the sun. And that's why we know that it is harmful for the sun. The most important part, right? Now, we will move forward and I'm going to tell you like how all these things have been working up and how all this, if you come back at this presentation, so you, I hope you have, all of you have understood that how modern day telescopes work and everything. So, now, there is another telescope known as James Webb Space Telescope. Now, this is the largest telescope humans have ever made. This is the largest space telescope. Remember, largest space telescope. So if you see this telescope, this will be launched next year. It is made by the NASA. It is the biggest. What is the primary aim of these space telescopes to observe in the universe? The primary aim of these telescopes is to see the first light coming from Big Bang. If you look at this picture, if you look at this chart, this is by NASA. In 1990s, we could only see just 6 billion years. Till 2004, we could only see just 800 million years. Till 2010, we could only see to 200 million years. Now in future, we can see less than 200 million years. Less than 200 million years means our universe is nearly 14 billion years old. So this means if we can see the light coming from 200 million years, it basically means that we can see the first light coming from the universe. This means the first single atom which produced the light we can see from the James Webb Space Telescope. Hopefully we can see. We are not confirmed that we will see or not, but we can see the farthest light coming from the universe. Now, there is another space telescope is known as Kepler Space Telescope. Remember, every telescope has its own meaning. Kepler was launched on March 7, 2009 in the name of the honor of Johannes Kepler. It was designed to survey the portion of the Milky Way to discover Earth-like planets and estimate how many stars in the Milky Way we have such planet. Kepler retired on November 15, 2018. In the period of 9 years, Kepler observed 530,506 stars and detected 2,662 planets. Now, this is very important to understand that all these planets that you're looking right now, right? These, some of them are discovered by Kepler space telescopes, not in the solar system. Like the planets which are outside our solar system, or maybe planets which orbit different stars. Our sun is a star, right? So different stars, those are known as exoplanets, right? And Kepler has discovered more than like 4,000 to 5,000 exoplanets. And it has observed more than 5 lakh stars in its time period. Now, we need to understand features of a telescope. Like, what is the basic principle of a telescope? The most important thing. The basic of a principle of a telescope is that if you had bigger eye, you would collect more light and see the object more brighter. Agar aapki aankhein badi hongi, to aap zyada bada dekh sakte hain, aur aap zyada light capture kar sakte hain. In the same way, agar telescope bahut bada hoga, uske paas utni capacity hogi, utni hi dur light dekhne ki, aur utni hi dur objects ko dekhne ki. If you have bigger eye, you will collect more light, you will see the more object the more bigger. In the same way, if you have bigger telescopes, you will see bigger and bigger far from the universe. In the same way, what I'm trying to tell you is that make sure that if you see, come back at this picture, if you see this is James Webb Space Telescope, then this is Hubble Space Telescope. If you come here, if you notice, the Hubble's mirror is 7.9 feet and JWST mirror is 21 feet. Now, how does basically a telescope works? Now, I will, if you are in class 12, remember this is going to come in board paper. There is a chapter in class 12 known as ray optics. And this question comes in ray optics. How does a telescope works? Incoming light. So what do I mean by incoming light? Incoming light, I mean light coming from moon, light coming from stars, light coming from anything. So what does happens? Incoming light hits the primary mirror. This is Johannes Kepler model. And this is a reflecting telescope. This is a model of Isaac Newton. And the light goes like this. So incoming light can be from any star. Incoming light can be from moon. Incoming light can be from Earth. Incoming light can be from any star. It goes inside the telescope. And then we have eyepiece. If you see this eyepiece, why do we have eyepiece? Eyepiece are basically those lenses which magnifies the object. An eyepiece lens takes bright light and then magnifies the object. When you combine the objective lens or primary mirror with eyepiece, we get a telescope. Simple, very, very simple. The light goes at the back of the mirror. It hits the secondary mirror. Then you put the eyepiece. Eyepiece is basically the lens. And it goes up and it magnifies the object. That's how a telescope works, basically. And list of observatories in India. Let's talk about some telescopes in India. The biggest telescope of Asia or South Asia is in India. That is Devsel Optical Telescope in Nainital. If you are from Nainital, you must be knowing about it. Or if you don't even know about it, it's okay. If you are from Uttarakhand, you will know about it. This is a 3.6 meter telescope operated by Aryabhatta Research Institute of Observational Sciences. It was launched in 2016 by the Indian Prime Minister and the Belgian Prime Minister. We have radio telescopes too. We have giant meter wave radio telescope in Pune. It is a 45 meter diameter telescope, which is operated by Tata Center for Radio Astrophysics and Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai. Then we have one of the world's smartest telescopes in India, that is Indian Astronomical Observatory in Halle. It is, if you read this very carefully, it is mentioned that it is the second highest optical telescope in the world. Second highest optical telescope in the world, situated at the elevation of 14,764 feet. If you see at the back of this picture, this is the night sky from Ladakh, Leh. It is the darkest place we have in India. The darkest sky you can ever see from India is in Ladakh, India. Kodaikanal Solar Observatory. We have solar observatory also. We have one in Kodaikanal. It's in Tamil Nadu. And we have Ooty Radio Telescopes also, which is near to Coimbatore, which is operated by Center for Radio Astrophysics and Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Then we have Udaipur Solar Observatory, which is in Udaipur. It is one of the most interesting places. It's near the lake. If you read what I've mentioned is that since the observatory is situated amidst a large mass of water, air turbulence which occurs due to ground heating by sunrise is decreased. This improves the image quality and accuracy. Like the ground heating which is happening, it increases the air turbulence. Hawa se jo turbulence hoti hai, hawa se jo teze bahut tez chal raha hai, pani usko rok deta hai, pani usko slow kar deta hai hawa ko. Right? Jisse image ki accuracy badh jati hai. To ye main kehna cha raha hu. And we have the second biggest telescope in India. We have Venu Bapu Observatory in Kabul. Venu Bapu Observatory is an astronomical observatory owned and operated by Indian Institute of Astrophysics. It is located at Kabul and in the Javadi Hills near Vanayambadi in Vellore district of the Indian state of Tamil Nadu. Thank you so much, guys. This was the end of the talk. Now I'm going to take the questions. Right. So to know more, please make sure that you follow us on Instagram. We have Fiddling Stars on Instagram and Spark Astronomy Official. And we are on Facebook. Also, if you are worried about, if you want to see this lecture later, after 2 hours, around 7 o'clock, this lecture will be posted. The recording of this lecture will be posted on Spark Astronomy's page, which is on Facebook page and YouTube channel of Aim to Innovate. Right. Apart from that, we will be inducting a lot more people. We will be doing a lot of things in the coming time. I'm going to share my journey also with you guys. But don't forget to follow Fiddling Stars on Instagram and Spark Astronomy Official on Instagram. Stay updated with us. We tell you about a lot of astronomy programs. If you're an astronomy enthusiast, make sure that you learn about astronomy and everything. And Instagram is the best place. I share all my photography. I share everything on Fiddling Stars. So make sure you follow it. And I hope if you have any questions, you can definitely type in the chat box. Apart from that, I can't take every question, but I will see the question which is relevant. I will take it. And thank you so much. I'm going to proceed with the question and answers now. And thank you. Make sure you follow us. Now, one by one, I'm going to take the question and answers. So if any of you have a question, just put it in the chat box. There is no option of opening your mic. I can't let you open your mic because there are so many people. It can create a hustle. But apart from that, you can tell me the question in the chat box. I can type.